And the nose really, really looks out onto a fantastic Weymouth Bay, the Jurassic coastline of South Dorset, about 3 hours from central London here. And we have the host area for the 2012 Olympic Games. Portland Harbour, we've just crossed it there. The nose is right in front of you on the left and out into the bay. But here's the course for the first of our RSX, and it's Peter Lester to describe it.
Windward and leeward course, up around the top, through the bottom mark gate, up around the top mark again for the second time, three laps. A downwind finish, down through the bottom mark gate, reaching at speed over towards the finish.
Well, there is the crowd again, and it's been wonderful. But although the sun is shining a little bit there, it's quite deceptive because it's significantly cooler here today in Weymouth and Portland. And although you might see one or two without jackets on, most of them who've got any sense at all will certainly be covering up, because the temperature has definitely dropped and the wind is a little bit fluky. You can see from the flags on the top of the nose there is the castle in the backdrop, background. They've got a wonderful view here, and these guys, I think, actually, they are getting as close as they possibly can to the action. This is the Nove Gardens. It's got a magnificent view, and there you can see the Dutch flag, all the orange supporters there. They know they've already celebrated the gold through Dorian van Rieselberger, and it's really just a question of who's going to pick up the silver and the bronze. But it's a magnificent setting for what is going to be a fabulous race, I'm sure. We've got the men to start with, and I guess you would say, Peter, that, there's a nice vision, isn't there? They're obviously enjoying themselves here on the nose in Weymouth. It has been a fantastic regatta.
Brilliant, brilliant regatta. We're about to do the medal races for the RSX men. That's the windsurfer discipline. Brilliant regatta, great venue, very well run. Not too many delays as we look down. The starting list, top 10. We already have our gold medalist, Dorian van Rieselberger from Denmark. Nick Dempsey, from Netherlands. Nick Dempsey and Tony Wilhelm, that is the fight there for the silver medal and bronze. And Poland, almost in, but he'd have to win the race. And then really anything below five, I don't think they've got much of a shot of a medal, but the medal race will be certainly the climax of the RSX for men. But what a performance to go into the medal race by the Dutchman to already have it tied up.
We've got LR4, the course there. And I'm
four
sure
laps. Yeah. So it's the windward leeward course with four laps, four windward beats, four downwind legs, and we are going to finish after they come through the bottom mark gate. They will make a turn to the left, then reach through the finishing line, downwind finish. It is cold. Look how the race committee, we're on the race committee boat, responsible for the race management, well rugged up. It's the weather forecast for Weymouth is not that great for the day. Later on we may well see, and that's indicating how much the race management team, wind shift, oscillating wind today. It's the stream is a little bit unstable, and coupled with that, expected rain later in the day. Southwester, just 12 knots at the moment. So it is unstable, it's tricky, but for this one, it's going to be a tricky race. It's a little bit unsettled today, and I think well advised to have their rain jackets on the north of crowd. It's cold, and rain expected.
The Swiss there just going out of picture, supporting Richard Stauffacher. He's back in 10th overall at the moment, and although he might well be out of the medals, there is the leader. He's got to start. Whether or not he actually finishes the race is another matter. He has been totally dominant. I mean, he was back in the pack in the World Championships. I think he was 5th overall in that World Championships, which the Frenchman Julien Bonneton actually won. Dempsey was just picked for that World Championship title, and he's in second place again. So the boy who spent most of his life here in Weymouth will be disappointed with this position, but it's been absolutely superb from Rieselberger. He's got six victories altogether, and that is quite unprecedented at an Olympic final. And in fact, in the 10th race, he'd already managed to win it. He didn't finish that one, he started it, and at the first mark he decided to go off, and he said, and I quote, "I'll leave it now to the other guys to sort out the minor medals." It's just an amazing thing. Poland are there with Przemyslaw Wiasinski, and well, after 10 races he's fourth, so he does have a chance of getting a medal. And there is a Polish supporter, and they do have a good view. They've got the screen and they've also got the binoculars to give them that extra little bit of enjoyment. It is a magnificent venue, brilliant to be able to see them, but with the shifting winds and things happening there, I'm sure that you will think, Peter, that it's a big challenge.
Yes, it is, and we're on for the medal race of the RSX for men. That's the warning signal has gone off, and a chance here for GBR to pick up a medal. The GBR team are thinking their high expectations have underachieved, really, as a team. We had that wonderful gold medal to Ben Ainsley in the Finn class, but really, they'll be looking for another medal here from their local boy, Nick Dempsey. He's second at the moment on 35 points, but he's going to come under the cosh, or under a challenge from Germany, Tony Wenholm. But the medal, the gold medal, is already tied up. But under the rules of the game, Dorian van Rysselberghe required to start. That is one of the requirements from the sailing instructions. We look at the clock, 4:05. The course, LR4, that essentially is four laps of the Windward Leeward course. The wind direction out of 225 southwest, but the wind flow is unstable. There is the threat of a bit of rain later in the day. They may well get this one off without rain, but what it means is it's not as stable. There's the gold medalist, the Olympic champion. Wonder how much of the race he'll do, John.
He will have respect for the race. And don't forget, this is the last time it's in the Olympic Games at the moment. It may never come back in. It's going to be replaced by kite surfing. So this could be the last time he sails, and I can't imagine that he would not try to win.
We'll see. What he will not do, I'm sure he will not interfere with the other medal contenders. There's certainly a protocol within the sport, I think. Dorian van Rysselberghe will do the race. He has to start, that's the requirement. That's the minimum requirement. 3 minutes is the Finnish contingent.
You see, what I really am quite amazed at how he has come through in the few months since that the World Championships in Cadiz in Spain earlier this year. He came through with Julian Bontomp actually winning that. Just have a chat about the actual board.
RSX
itself.
Board. Out of from Pride, it's a Pride One design. They're all exactly the same, and this is not about a technology race. It is about the skill, and there is the sailor. It has completely dominated the regatta. Big, tall, rangy. He is 6'3". He weighs 80 kilos. So the fight is on. Nick Dempsey, can he get a silver medal for Team GBR? Dempsey, he won the World Championships in this class in 2011 in Western Australia in Perth. He was fourth at the 2012 Worlds in Cadiz in Spain.
It's interesting that he did actually say in his ambitions file, in his bio data, that he says to do his best at the 2012 Olympic Games rather than to win an Olympic gold, which you see on most of the biodata. So he's obviously realistically looking at trying to get a medal, but as we can see, the line set before us, they're both in front and behind in the pre-start at the moment, and there is some very, very keen eyes looking at this extraordinary vista. The wind just a little bit shifty, but I think one of the things about board sailing is that they have, more than any other sailors, have got a handle on it. They are very, very quick to react.
Very intuitive, and they're relying on what the board sailors rely on is actually sailing in pressure as opposed to wind shifts. They don't tack that well, these boards on the upwind. We're inside the last minute. That was the signal, 50 seconds to go. As soon as the Netherlands, Dorian van Wisselberg, goes over the line, he is the Olympic champion, but the fight is on for silver and bronze in the RSX men windsurfer. 32 seconds. There's Jean-Paul Tobin.
He's back in seventh at the moment overall and could make a push, but he's got 80 points altogether. It's not going to get him up for a medal.
No, he's not going to get up for a medal. And, of course, it's New Zealand who won the gold medal in Beijing. That Tom Ashley, not selected by New Zealand, quite controversial. Anyway, coming up to 6 seconds to go as the fleet reach down towards the leeward end. 2 seconds. It's going to be a clean start. We're underway in the middle race for RSX for men.
It's a superstar. Richard Stauffacher comes really strongly for Switzerland, followed by the Pole, who is really going well, Premislav Miosinski. And there's the French sailor as well. Julian Bonton, but they will all keep going there. Dempsey is in the lead.
Dempsey, a lovely start. Beautiful start by Dempsey in the medal race. So he is looking strong off the line. Poland down to leeward. Poland well forward on the fleet, and there's the gold medalist just playing it safe. Doesn't need to do any more. He started the race. We have an Olympic champion in RSX for men.
In the last 10 minutes, Peter, it's gone from 12 to 15 knots, and you can tell already it's really beginning to get very exciting.
Yes, they're underway. The wind is up a little bit. It's meant to be shifty, and it's the pressure is meant to be up and down as they head up towards the top mark. GBR to windward looks in a good position there, with Poland got a bit of a flyer. Heading up towards the top mark. You just see the boards coming into shot, how quick they are.
That area of the nose is called Newton's Cove, with the promenade behind it, and again, not that well populated at the moment because it is pretty chilly, I have to say. But these guys are nicely set up here with their half-cut wetsuits at least. But Poland look as if they're in the lead here. Netherlands in second space, with GBR in third, but we haven't actually had a look over the top to see how high they are.
Yeah, we haven't had a wide view, but certainly as they track, there's Dempsey tacking away. Poland ahead of the Netherlands. Well, there's been great support for the sailors, especially the GBR team here in Weymouth.
They can pump though, Peter, can't they?
They can definitely pump, and that's one of the real skills, especially when the wind lightens a wee bit. Down at the bottom, it was quite fresh. Now, as they get up towards the top third, the wind will get lighter towards the top of the course, and we can see that pumping at Germany are back. Wilhelm is back. Dempsey is well ahead. So right now for the silver, Dempsey looks in strong position. Van Rysselberg, it was interesting, even though he's already won the gold, he appears with his extreme height. He's a big, tall, rangy board sailor athlete, and I think that gives him a bit more leverage, and if you can really translate that leverage into horsepower, of course you go faster.
In terms of the relative position of this course and vis-a-vis the land, there is a big, big outcrop off to the left here, and that will make a big difference. It's definitely the lighter airs as they're trying to get to the buoy there. It's in the wind shadow area of Portland Harbour itself.
Yeah, just a little bit shadowed with the wind from this direction. Bonton, Julian Bonton, who currently lies in sixth position, probably a little bit deep in the fleet in terms of overall points to get up. This is the medal race, double point scoring for this one. 2 points for first, 20 points for the 10th position. Dempsey having a good regatta. Certainly he would be, I think, if Dempsey gets second in this one, looking at his track record over the last few years, he'd be pretty happy with that result.
He'll be very
if
happy
he can medal, because the rest of the GBR team, other than that disappointment really for Percy in the star class, are expected to perform and into the top mark. First in, we've got the gold medalist. He's just faster than the other guys. That's on the upwind.
Amazing.
He was behind off the line, but it is Netherlands first, the Olympic champion. Second, we've got France. Then we've got Dempsey. Good power around the mark by Dempsey to come over the top of Bontemps. Who have we got in here next? That's Bontemps from France. Greece. Brazil. I was just looking out really to find if have we seen Poland.
Yes, they went ahead.
They're Poland
Greece.
Around, but yeah. They, for the points, they trail GBR. But Poland are ahead of Germany. So we'll just monitor as this one unfolds. But look at the style of this guy. Easy, 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 easy. And he looks so in tune with the environment, the conditions. He has had, it's an unbelievable week he's had when you look at his scorecard.
Quite extraordinary.
He's just littered with first placings to the extent that he didn't have to race in the final race of the round robin.
Six of them, six first.
And all he had to do was start this one, and he's already out to 91 metres.
Quite extraordinary, considering that Bontemps was the world champion from earlier. But these are different conditions from the Mediterranean, of course. There's going to be a little bit cooler condition. Shooting the Dutch boy here, he has been absolutely magnificent. And that, anybody can make the board move that fast deserves it. He has been in a class of his own. This guy's done well, though, and I'm sure, considering that he had this unbelievable leader ahead of him all the time, it would have been frustrating, but he's kept his concentration and doing pretty well here, trying to secure that silver medal.
Downwind angles, they are actually going directly downwind, but because of the way the board works, they actually sail a reaching angle, jibing through probably close to 95, 100 degrees at the bottom mark. Mark two, and it is the Olympic champion, and he's going to finish. He's going to finish this thing off in style. He wants to win the race. This is the last time we'll see RSX in the Olympic Games. They have been replaced for the next Olympic by kiteboarding. Quite a controversial decision as France Bontemps is second. Now, I look at the points. No, he cannot get up to a medal position. But Dempsey comes round third. So that will certainly be pleasing for Team GBR. So,
well, it means Dempsey,
he's lying in second. Just to point out, John, on the right on the tip of the board, see right on the bow, that's the little GPS unit that sends up the signal that gives us the tracking, so we know where the boards are on the course relative to each other. Again, one of these very nice little innovations we've seen here at London 2012. And they really have tried hard to make sailing, windsurfing, more understandable, really, to us all, to the public, as we look at Germany coming. Now, Germany are currently third going into this. It's going to come under attack. Germany, Poland are ahead, I think. It just depends what happens on the points. What have we got there? He's got 46 versus 52. I think that'll possibly move Poland up to bronze, but we're not even halfway through yet.
It will do. What you've just assumed is actually
that's assuming they stay where they are. And one thing that happens in these RSX for men windsurfers, they don't they jump around the field. Look, there's that pumping action. And that's why the windsurfing sailors are regarded as some of the most athletic, the fittest, the strongest. They really are true athletes that sail these things.
Generally for youngsters. And you mentioned that you were on one of the first boards.
Yeah, but badly. Nothing like this. Very badly.
Me too, but I've also thoroughly enjoyed them. I have my own board on holiday, having an absolute ball with them. They are just such wonderful fun, no doubt at all.
But at this level, look, he is completely in harmony with the board. He's in his harness. He's got gold already signed up. Between the boards there's quite a bit of separation. That's
Julian Bontomp.
Bontomp down to leeward. It's Dempsey, who currently in second. Dempsey will be just monitoring in terms of medals. As long as he keeps a track of Germany, Wilhelm, and the pole, he's got this one signed up.
Let's just discuss. You are a natural sailor. What's the difference, actually, between board sailing and regular dinghy sailing?
Well, basically, on a board, you haven't got a rudder to steer the thing. So the way they steer is by their feet, balance, and also the way they handle the sail. By rocking it back, it actually means the board will come further around into the wind. If they push the mast and the sail forward, the board will actually bear off. But their ability to sail the board without a rudder, and in terms of their accuracy, is really the skill that is just to behold, really. It's phenomenal as we look at Van Rysselberghe. In some ways, the medal race in this one, with the winner already being determined, I'm not saying it's an anti-climax, but because they're racing for silver and bronze, but the idea of the medal race is that the regatta will be decided in the medal race. But in this class, the Dutchman has been so dominant, he's already won the medal. And why is he so dominant? He's fitter, he's stronger. The conditions here have obviously suited him. It's been rather fresh, there's been plenty of wind. Being 6'2" and 80 kilos, he can transfer that power into speed. Bontemps. There's a bit of a change there. That's a lovely lay line by
GBR on the left.
GBR, but watch the grease.
They
can hit the mark. He can trouble. Hit the mark, but he's coming
trouble.
In.
He's
a little
in
bit
trouble.
Shallow. No, he's got a tack, underlaid it. So that opened the door up for Dempsey. Dempsey had a spot on Leyland. It was looking pretty good for the Greek sailor.
Byron Coquelin has got a bit greedy there, yeah, I think. Well,
but again, you can see how much you pay for a manoeuvre.
And he went out against Poland as well there. So not
now, Poland has got a spot back. They were back. Is that going to help Poland?
Yeah, it's definitely. That will give them bronze medal.
So bronze. Poland are trying to get points between himself and Germany, so that little maneuver at the top mark by Greece certainly helped the Polish sailor in terms of his medal aspirations. How are the conditions? Staying about 15 knots from 225, so there's no change.
But the umbrellas are up, we just saw that.
Raining?
Yeah.
Oh, how unusual,
John. Don't you go there. He hates the weather, he hates
no,
the water,
I don't.
It's so
no,
cold.
No, I don't. It's a lovely place. Look, I'm very complimentary to Weymouth. I think other than it being pretty chilly and a bit wet, it's the sailing water, to be quite frank, I think it's been the best Olympic venue that I've experienced for sailing. The whole package, the race management, the racing areas, the five race areas have been wonderful.
At least we haven't had a lack of it.
No, and that's right. Very few delays. Very, very few delays. And certainly that's one of the key ingredients. The ability just to flick the board around, come back onto the wind as we head. This is the third time upwind.
We had a laser radio sailor yesterday, Lucy Jiao. And you said that was the best sailing you'd seen for a long time in terms of its poetry of movement. It was just such accuracy and beautiful, beautiful movement. I think we can compare that with Van Rysselberghe. He's got that feel of total authority.
Van Rysselberghe is in another league in this regatta. There's no doubt about that. As Dempsey comes around, just looks more workmanlike to me.
Yeah, he does.
But he's good enough, he's going to...
Gempo.
That's great.
Gempo, that could be a Kiwi.
Could be an Australianism. But he has done the business, and Team GBR really had huge expectations for a lot of medals here in Weymouth, and they've already got two, so...
You know, Byron Coquelanis, you just saw him come through there. Not only did he miss out at the top mark, he's actually had the Brazilian Ricardo Santos pass him as well. So he really did make a huge gamble. It didn't pay off at the top mark.
heading back up to the top mark for the third time. This is the last time you will see windsurfing in the Olympic Games. Bjørn van Rysselberg has completely dominated the class. He will be Olympic champion, and he's going to go out
as the last Olympic champion.
As the last, but he's going to go out in style.
Allez, Julien
Bonton. Bonton from France, great. Certainly one of the iconic windsurfer countries, Bonton. See how much shorter and smaller he is than the regatta winner, and that the physical attributes are so important in terms of height and weight. If you're tall and rangy with the right weight, you have a big leverage advantage. As I flick through, I'll pick out his bio, just have a little look. Well, he's actually 6 foot. Bonton, Nick Dempsey comes through. He's a bit shorter, 5'11". They're all about 70 kilos, the board sailors. And Rysselberg's actually a bit heavier at 80 kilos. Now, what that would tell me is that it's been, in terms of the race stats, it's been quite a windy series. And I think that's why that extra 10 kilos Bjørn van Rysselberg's had. He's been able to use that to his advantage in the fresher conditions.
It's an interesting one here that Julien Bonton, we've seen several cutaways of him. The Frenchman has been second in Beijing in 2008 at the Olympic Games, so he is a silver medalist. And right behind him, Nick Dempsey, who finished in fourth place in Beijing, is actually taking that silver medal from him. So it's a really, really close encounter.
Look at that.
Fantastic.
20, about a lot more than 20 knots. Already heading down to the bottom mark again, the Olympic champion.
Such accuracy.
Sorry, he was coming in from the top mark. They go as fast upwind as downwind. Look at this. Dempsey's got back at him. So Dempsey, smart move. He went out to the right.
Yep.
Now, how hard are they going to fight together?
this is
first
great.
And second in the regatta.
This is fantastic.
So wow.
Listen to the crowd there.
Dempsey has got in the middle race. Right back into it. That's a good upwind by Dempsey. And the speeds are so high, it doesn't take much to chop 100 metres out of the opposition. So the two leading boats are going towards the right on screen. There's
fourth
coming around the top mark. Big separation.
You know, I think at that mark, it looks like Bonton has taken them all. He has. Look at that. Wow. Bonton is leading from...
So the right-hand side of the track, we didn't have that in shot. Bonton has got into the lead.
Yes.
On that second upwind, third upwind.
Not only in the lead, he's
miles in the lead.
Miles in the lead. He's 30
big wind shift. There's been a big shift on the course to the right. So at mark six, it's Bonton comes through to the lead. What's that going to do to the points? No, he doesn't have enough to get up.
He hasn't, but look at the French celebrating. I mean, the world champion from this year has suddenly found a way.
In comes our Olympic champion, second.
That's interesting that he's gone straight off to
the right.
Yeah.
It's where Bonton did the damage on the third upwind. We're on the fourth upwind. This is the last windward leg. Fast and furious, but not that tactical, to be honest. They really rely on extreme speed, extremely good handling of the board and lay lines.
Poland fourth.
Poland fourth coming in, and then
Canada.
Canada's got up.
Wow, so Germany around this.
Brazil.
Germany have fallen back. Wilhelm told me, Tony Wilhelm, who had the third position prior to this, has just really struggled.
So at that bottom mark, by my reckoning, we will have the Olympic champion will be
and
then
confirmed.
That's confirmed. Then we'll have Dempsey.
Yep.
And then we're going to have a change
Primozov
with Mazinski coming up. Yep. into third. That's a disappointing result for Wilhelm. And that's the idea of the medal races, really, that the spectators have something to cheer for. But certainly that is a change. But Dempsey.
Yeah, look at him looking anxiously over his shoulder.
Not far to go, just up to the top mark. And then we're on the reach down, the run down to the finish. So it is Bontemps in the lead. He's been a world champion.
Yeah, present world champion.
In real terms, he is the 2012 world champion. It was in Cadiz. Now, I keep harping on about conditions, and that would have been a bit lighter down there, and more importantly, lighter and warm. And when the wind is warm, it has less density. Less density means less power. So there's a big change. You might say, well, why hasn't he capitalised here, being the world champion in Weymouth? The conditions are so different to what the regatta was in Cadiz in Spain. So there is
Tony Wilhelm, and
he will be disappointed. We're back at the top mark already. This is the last mark as Bontemps comes up, tacks. You can see the speed is washed off. He gives the sail a bit of a flick. Boat gets back onto the plane. The board gets back onto the plane as
great accuracy
Misselberg comes round, and they are now on the run to the finish.
Just 5 seconds separating them. Can we see a real grandstand finish here from Van Rysselberger? It will be a wonderful thing if he manages it. Dempsey there, pumping hard as securing silver medal position, and he's getting a great round of applause from the crowd here on the nose. But the biggest disappointment will be for the German supporters. Tony Wilhelm has been raced out of it here. Poland coming up really, really well. Przemyslaw Miazinski. And France and Netherlands. Just look at the Netherlands. Boy, he's gone.
There's a lead change. A lead change. He wants to take this one out in style.
That is brilliant. Right in front of the crowd.
Right in front. And that put that down to technique and horsepower. Basically, he's big, he's strong, he's got more ability to pump.
What a showman. Right in front of the crowd.
Van Rysselberg from the Netherlands. Down to the bottom mark. The finishing line is now in sight. In the lead, we've got Netherlands, Van Rysselberg, France, Bontemps, Nick Dempsey in third position. They are coming down to the finish. Through comes the leader. On the small reach to the finish now, Doran Van Rysselberg, no passing lanes. There is the finishing line as Van Rysselberg comes through. The shake of the fist. The RSX men, windsurfer, Olympic gold medalist, Olympic champion from the Netherlands.
Unbelievable there. Just fantastic. And all the crowd, not just the Dutch supporters, but they're all cheering that brilliant performance by the Dutchman. But coming in now in the third place in this race, but second overall, the silver medalist Nick Dempsey. He'll be delighted with that. He was fourth place, the worst possible place in Beijing. He's now got second place here, silver medal. And just look at this, the golden silver medalist absolutely there. And there's the pole. He's come up from beating Tony Wilhelm, and Przemyslaw Miazinski takes the bronze. And the crowd over the top of the crowd, really threatening there. But wow, what a finish. Brilliant, brilliant. Have you seen anything like that in terms of declaration of superiority? Rysselberger looked as if he'd lost out to the Frenchman, Julien Bontemps, to win the race, but he overtook him in front of the crowd.
Yeah,
what a
right.
Drama.
Oh, well, that's the sign of a champion. There he is. Enjoy the moment. Quite a tight camaraderie in the group. They are a special breed, the windsurfers. As we look at, there's another medal, silver medal for GBR. As we're looking out really to for Germany, yeah. I think already the bronze medal is tied up.
That's the Swiss Richard Stauffacher. as the...
As the rain comes down. Oh, nice.
I told you the cloud was up and up. The cloud on the crowd.
He will not be feeling any of those raindrops. He will be very, very happy.
Maybe in the sunshine.
And off go the crowd. And I think that's the Dutch supporters.
They've taken over a house.
Go, Dorian.
They've taken a house over in that bay, in the Newton's Cove Bay, and they're going to have a party now. The last time that we actually saw
John Paul Tobin coming through. Tobin from New Zealand.
He was in seventh place before this final round. But there's no doubt at all. But this final, there is the German. What a disappointment for him. Tony Wilhelm gets a charitable round of applause. But number three on the sale, it will be transferred off. And that will be put on the sale of Przemyslaw Miazinski. But this is the last time we'll be seeing RSX Windsurfer sailing in the Olympics at the moment, certainly in the foreseeable future. And, well, that makes it momentous in itself.
Well, it does. Disappointment for the Wilhelm from Germany. He was in the bronze position going into the medal race. He hasn't had a great race. He's back in ninth position. And he won't be entirely happy with that.
There's the Paul Miazinski.
There's the Olympic champion. As he hops on board the rib, grabs the flag, thanks his coach, Team GBR. They'll be happy, I'm sure. Julien Bontemps, the French supporters.
It's a real fraternity, the windsurfing fraternity, I can tell you. They are, as you mentioned before, supremely fit athletes. They have got to be to play at this level. Anyone can try windsurfing. Anybody can try it at any level. But at this level, my golly, they really are supreme athletes. And they are very proud of the fact that they are considered within the sailing fraternity.
A little bit of politicking. Windsurfer for Rio. It is quite controversial, the decision to drop the windsurfer for the kiteboarder. And in fact, I do believe there's an attempt being made by the class to have ISAF, the International Sailing Federation, reconsider that decision. But we won't go into the politics of all that as we look at our Olympic champions. First, second, third. Third to Poland. Wow.
He's delighted.
He'll be happy. Oh, fourth to third.
And he did it in style. I mean, he had to pick up 6 points, so he needed to be up near the front. And that really is very, very impressive. And he's done it very, very well indeed. Canada did well too.
There's Canada coming through, but really all the talk is about the first, second and third. We have our Olympic champion, a new Olympic champion, Dorian Van Wisselberg, and did it in style. Love the conditions here in Weymouth. Canada comes through.
That's Zach Klavzic. Ends up in 10th position in that particular race, and overall he wouldn't have improved on his 8th position. But there he is with the Dutch flag. Look at that.
Very cool.
Excellent. Well, what do you say about a guy that is so dominant in a race? He just had the feel for the conditions. He understood the race. They really were. Not, it wasn't just a human and a piece of gear, the board. They were very much the unit, weren't they?
Oh, very together. Much. No, it all came together, and that would have come about. Nick Dempsey, he'll be pleased, very pleased with his second position, silver for GBR. That gives GBR what? A gold and two silvers now in the middle count.
Yeah, that Percy.
That was an upset. This is not an upset. I think this is a very pleasing result for that team.
Ricardo Santos, supported there by the Brazilians, and of course we're going to be in his home patch, but possibly without windsurfing next time. I tell you, half of his mates are out on the nose there right now.
They are watching. And look at that, lovely shot.
Brilliant.
We don't even need to talk over it. That's great. They are a close-knit group. Look at
me.
Swam over. Congratulatory hug. And off we go.
And I got a feeling, wasn't Royal Schweitzer, wasn't the inventor of the windsurfing out of Holland?
That's, yes, I think you're dead right. Well, you've been doing your research.
No, it's just that my first time on a board, I seem to remember that. Yeah, it's so appropriate that the last Olympic event should be won by a guy from the inventor's home nation.
Very good. So Dorian van Rysselberghe wins the medal race. Julian Bontemps and Nick Dempsey.
Great crowds. They've got a lot more sailing to enjoy later on today. But in the meantime, it's back to the shore and the celebrations to start, I'm sure, for van Rysselberghe. He's known about it for a long time. That's the overall 15 points. Absolutely blew them away. Dempsey will be very happy with his silver. And look at this, come from behind. Bronze medal for the Pole, Przemyslaw Miazinski.
And Rysselberghe, coached by Aaron McIntosh, also an Olympic medalist. So McIntosh will be certainly pretty happy. There's McIntosh seeing the coach boat, also acknowledging the crowd, acknowledging his best friend and his coach. And so much effort goes into preparing for this class. Very physical, a lot of multi-sport training. He loves surfing, wakeboarding. A lot of the sailors now use biking or road bike as a cross training, and van Rysselberghe, not surprisingly, is also a cyclist.
And Przemyslaw Miazinski, absolutely delighted that he's got up to take a medal home. It's so important. And there is a lot of importance attached to medals, but actually, you know, in the great scheme of things, every one of them getting here into the medal race, the top 10, have done a brilliant job, and they've sacrificed a lot in their lives to get to this stage. But to take home a medal as well, that's a big bonus.
Oh, it certainly is. And again, I look at the result, first, second and third, three countries from the colder climates.
Yep.
And I think that is the biggest change I have seen here in Weymouth, is the balance of power really is gone to Poland, in this case Netherlands, Great Britain, Poland. There's Aaron McIntosh. He would be absolutely delighted, coach and athlete.
The mutual respect you see there, but look at him, he's saying he's the man, and then the humility of these guys. Actually,
Aaron McIntosh, he's also Olympic medalist on the Mistral IMCO class in Sydney 2000. He's a Kiwi, and he has been coaching his good mate, Dorian van Rysselberghe. A bit of a replay, off they go, clean start, only 10 boards, and it was Nick Dempsey was initially launched off the line, and really that start set up Dempsey for us to maintain his silver medal. And I think the bad start by Germany, Tony Wilhelm, really cost him a medal.
Yeah.
Bare feet, cold water, nice.
I just thought it was like you coming to work every day, Peter.
So good. They don't even need to use their hands. It's all about balance, coordination. I'm in awe of the windsurfers. There's the Olympic champion and the Olympic silver medalist.
You think that was a little bit dangerous, wouldn't you? But
Seems to be a new phenomenon down in Weymouth to see the Olympic winners letting off flares or the crowd.
Oh, it's just a great scene, a wonderful festival, and you can see there's commentators even on the water there, just bringing all this wonderful action to you. It is a privilege to be here with the crew that actually bring all the pictures, because they have been superb, from the helicopters and from all the cameras on the boats as well. It's a tough job bringing these pictures to you wherever you are in the world, but you can see, despite the conditions, and probably sometimes because of the conditions, it's great to be here. And there, the max, these little temporary coverings. But it hasn't deterred this crowd here at Weymouth, at the move in Portland. The French guy did a great job there in getting second place, but he would not be denying Nick Dempsey on this occasion. He actually came over because Dempsey replaced him as the silver medalist for the Olympic Games. well, as you say, great camaraderie.
Windsurfing. Well,
should we get into it?
No, we won't get into that. No. They are characters. I don't know if I'd...
I think
that's not advisable for normal people in powerboats. But, certainly,
what we want to see now is him steering with his right foot.
Well, I'm sure he can. Great shot.
Wonderful atmosphere in Portland. And coming up in the not-too-distant future, we've got the women's version of the same event, the RSX Women in Just a While. There's the interviews already taking place with Nick Dempsey, obviously the home crowd favourite, getting him first around the microphone.